At 24, here's meteorologist Tom DeVecchio, your weather authority.
Cloudy skies, and we've had some snowfall, almost 3 inches along the lakeshore for several of you. And we had about 2 inches here at our studios, two and a half from last night. We squeezed another 1/2 to 1 inch since daybreak. And you can see a pretty dark out over the bay at this point, but most of the flakes of snow not falling here. The big news, of course, will be the cold air. The snow showers, most of them have been offshore on that good southwesterly flow. And really the big questions is wind direction and wind chill. So let's first go with the cold weather safety. Many thanks to Dan Rupp for making this graphic for us here. What are some of the things you should do? First of all, protect the elderly, pets, livestock, and certainly infants. They are the most susceptible to cold. And when we have wind chills down to minus 30 beginning later tomorrow into Thursday, where a frostbite can occur in just a few minutes if you're left outside, that's especially important. Fill up your gas tank. Don't want the lines to freeze. Have at least a half a tank of gas, if not a full tank. Ensure your water pipes don't freeze. You can turn on the water and let it run very lightly, just a little drip. That'll help. The movement will help keep the pipes from freezing. Dress properly for the outdoors. Layers, 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 and you cover everything. And I mean everything when you get wind chills down to minus 25. The kids are outside, even waiting for the bus. For those who have school tomorrow and into Thursday, they need to be covered as much as possible. And update your winter car survival kit. If for some reason you get stuck, check your battery as well. You can go to many of the local auto stores. They'll check it for free to see just how good your battery is. A weak battery may have a hard time starting with the kind of cold temperatures we're expecting. And it's pretty cold right now. We're at 36 at midnight. We're looking at the temperatures mainly in the lower to mid-20s. Corey out toward French Creek. 1 to as much as 3 inches fell. The higher amounts, once again, along the lakeshore, we seem to be in the path of the heaviest snows of late, and we could be again with this cold air outbreak. Low, solid low 20s here. Canada Lake through Sagertown, Westmead, Saybrook, Gary 25, Pittsfield 22. Getting some reports of some snow bands moving through, but they shouldn't amount to really any real problems as you plan your travels for today. But it's cold enough now. Wind chill single digits to around 10 above. This will feel warm compared to what we're expecting the next couple of days. But to make no mistake, we are cold as well for today. The winds have been shifting actually more almost due south compared to southwest. That's moving a lot of those bands out over the lake for now. And we will keep that southwest flow through the day. Now, along with the extreme cold that we're going to get over the next couple of days, what are the chances of lake effect? Looks like as we head on through tomorrow, Wednesday, most of the winds will be mainly southwest like they are now. That should keep the heaviest bands offshore. As this trough comes in for tomorrow night into Thursday, that's kind of the X factor here. If it gets close enough, it could shift our winds more west at times for Thursday, for Wednesday night into Thursday. So from my biggest thinking, midnight tomorrow night to noon on Thursday, we have a chance of seeing some of those bands come on shore, at least from Erie to Edinburgh. I don't see it going any farther south. That's something we will watch. This afternoon, though, mostly cloudy on the lakeshore, some light snow showers. Temperatures holding near 20. Light snow on the inland side. Your temperatures holding in the lower 20s. Chautauqua-Allegheny area, a little bit of light snow, and temperatures 20 to 25. Bitter cold tonight, below zero. Wind chills to minus 25. Maybe some light snow showers. Highs tomorrow, zero on the thermometer. Wind chills to minus 30 with wind gusts over 30 miles an hour. And again, we'll be watching for the possibility of some lake effect bands, mainly late in the day. And we'll be watching the potential for lake effect bands for tomorrow night and into Thursday with temperatures in the single digits again for Thursday. Still cold on Friday. Saturday, 33. That might be a little optimistic. May not get out of the 20s, but we should get to the 40s. By Sunday. Any changes to that forecast, even hourly reports, can be found anytime on our website, yourerie.com. And if there's any closings or delays, also on our website. You want to watch it.
Yeah, and of course, we're telling you this today. We'll be back here tomorrow morning telling you again as you bundle up to sort of head wherever you have to go tomorrow. Hopefully it's not far, though.
We're hoping it is. Hope it's not.
Coming up next on Jeff 24, action isn't new.